They're lowering the GPU prices. PlayStation games coming to PC isn't all sunshine and rainbows, and Intel's GPU. Why won't they tell us more? Let's get into the hot news, everybody. I'm your Brett host. We're going to go over the hottest tech news that I can find on the internet for you while you enjoy your breakfast. Welcome back this lovely Monday morning. And I'm going to dive right in into the first topic, which is GPU prices dropping. We talked about this in last week's episode that there might be some hope for companies like NVIDIA, HP, and Zotac who are submitting documents to the US government to try to repeal the 25% tariff that currently exists on GPUs. But on top of that, we have some insider information with regards to at least one vendor who's producing NVIDIA GPUs, and that they're lowering their cards prices by up to $94. So this is coming courtesy of some MSI insider information reporting that the company is reducing their pricing on their GPUs. The RTX 3080 series will get a price drop between $47 and $94. The 3070 will get a price drop between $16 and $31, and the 3060 series will get a price drop between $15 and $31, which obviously doesn't resolve all of the issues that we're having with GPU pricing. I heard everybody last week was like, 25% doesn't negate the 300% increase we have, Brett. I get it. I understand that. But having things cheaper at the source likely will result in things becoming slightly cheaper at the end side, or it just might result in miners having higher profit margins. Who knows? I'm just speculating here. But one of the thoughts that I read with connection to this is that you don't drop price unless you have less demand. So could it be that people are petering out on their RTX 30 series desires for their GPUs, and that's why they're dropping pricing? Or is it supply chain related, where they actually don't necessarily have as high of cost to do all of that? Which, by the way, quick question, why is petering out such a negative thing? What did Peter do to get such a negative comment associated with his name? I don't know, but I do know that while NVIDIA GPUs might be going down on MSI side, on the other hand, AMD cards are going up. We talked about this previously, that AMD is likely raising their prices. Gigabyte is also raising their prices. And now we've got reports that Sapphire is looking to raise its price by $79 on the 6900 series, $63 on the 6600 XT, and $55 increase on the 6600, which is probably the one that hurts the most considering that's the cheapest card out there. So not every GPU is seeing a price decline in the same report that's telling us that GPU prices are going down. We also get reports that GPU prices are going up. Is it because Samsung's better than TSMC? Is it because NVIDIA is better than AMD? Or is it because the world's in a giant state right now where everybody's having a hard time making anything, and it's just going to continue to result in us not having our gaming goods? How will we live without our gaming goods? And I don't know how I'll live with anything less than a terabyte of RAM in the next few years. Last week, we talked about a report that AMD's next-gen Zen 4 EPYC CPUs will support 12 channels of DDR5 memory. Well, now there's more information that not only is it 12 channels, it's 12 terabytes, 12 flipping terabytes of total memory bandwidth. And when you put all of them together, it can run at 4,000 megatransfers per second, which is just blistering my mind right now. It's wrinkling my brain, my friends. And I'm here to wrinkle your brain with the hottest tech deals that are across the internet, which, by the way, I actually got our old UFD deals site back up and running. I'm kind of like soft launching it right now. So in case you ever see one of the deals that I present in this episode of Hot News and you're wondering if it's still good, I'm gonna try to keep the website up to date. So just go to ufd.deals for you to find all of the latest tech deals that are out on the internet, the hottest ones that you could possibly find. So in case you want to check that out, give me some feedback. This is a soft launch. I did my best to kind of throw together something that works. And I know that there's a few things that I still need to tweak. It doesn't have all of the deals. It will build up a repository as we go along. But UFD deals officially back. So let's just go through the quickest ones we got. XPG's Gamex S70 1 terabyte PCI Express 4.0 drive, 7,400 megabytes per second read, going for $125 after an Amazon coupon. The Thrustmaster T-Flight HOTUS for the PS4 and PC, also support on the PS5, going for only $50. That's $40 off, almost half the price. ViewSonic has their 27-inch 1440p 144Hz IPS 1 millisecond response time gaming monitor going for $240, which is about $100 off. That is an insane price for a 1440p 144Hz monitor. Again, link for all of that will be in the video description. And let's link this section to the Crypto Stonks section and talk about Bitcoin going going up just like 0.3%. It's still below 50,000. It was over 50,000 for the majority of Sunday, but it's gone down a little bit. Ethereum down 0.5% to be at roughly $4,000, down from where it was hovering, which was in like the low 4,000s. Now it looks like it could potentially even dip below that. Dogecoin down a little bit as well to sit at 16.8 cents. The meme stonks having a slightly better time. GameStop closing up Friday 2%, and AMC closing down, having a worse time, down to 27.44. AMC's just been getting hammered these last few weeks. Like, it was crossing up to $50 at one point, and this back down to 25, baby, that's where you go. But while AMC might be going down, Ford wants to go up with their Mustang Mach-E, with the CEO of Ford announcing that they're gonna be tripling their output of the Mach-E in 2022 to 200,000 units because it's in high demand. How are they going to do that? Well, according to the reports, it's because they're gonna be kind of slowing out the roll of the Ford Explorer EV as well as the Aviator EV that they were planning on rolling out, and just kind of pushing all of their attention to the Mustang. But you wanna put your attention on a Tesla, or at least Tesla owners want you to give you them your attention is what I'm trying to say. And now they have the best way to do it, with a gosh dang super horn, my friends. We're finding out about this from some leaked documents that are coming from the Berlin Gigafactory that's happening, indicating that the super horn will combine the horn, the alarm, and the loudspeaker that are on the outside of the Tesla Model 3 and Model Y to make it so that you just blast people with as much noise as possible. Why would you need a super horn? I don't know. I do really wish there was more options when it comes to like car horns. You have like the faint little, hey, you're not paying it. I see you on your phone at the red light. Can you go now, please? Like just a gentle boop, like, hey. That's what I want coming out. Just go, all right? But then there's times where it's like, you're being a real butt face and I wanna go, where? Moving on from this topic. That's the noise that SSDs have been making on Windows 11 because there's been a bug that's been existing where certain drives, when they're indicated to be the C drive on Windows 11, are having half the write speed but totally fine read speeds. Microsoft finally fixing this and making it so that you get the full speed of your SSD, because, you know, writing to your drive is kind of an important task. Having half of that is no good. Also, them fixing the issue that we talked about last week, where if you try to dial 911 on your Android phone but you had Microsoft Teams app installed but not logged in, it would prevent you from doing that. Microsoft releasing an update. Google going to release an update to the Android operating system to prevent this from ever happening again on January 4th, so you can expect that. But also, Android announcing that they're gonna have Google Play games coming to the Windows in 2022, which is a little weird because we are getting Android apps that are coming to Windows 11, but that's not going through Google's official route. That's like Amazon's Android Play Store, whereas like the Google Play Store is gonna be a different implementation. And it just, I'm kind of like, what's going on here that Google announced this, number one, at the Video Game Awards, made it like a really big deal. But then number two, did something happen behind closed doors with Google and Microsoft where they couldn't come to terms, and Microsoft was just like, you made an open source app, we're gonna go get somebody else. We don't need Google officially. And then Google was like, oh darn, probably should have taken their deal. I don't know, I'm just speculating. But I do know that there is some beef when it comes to Apple in communicating with all of these game developers, making it really difficult to run game ecosystems on their operating system. And now reports are coming out from the Epic versus Apple lawsuit that Sony, number one, tried to get PlayStation Now to run on iPhones back in 2017. That was unsuccessful. Apple wouldn't change their stance. More reports of Microsoft also trying to get xCloud and Xbox games onto the iPhone, and Apple just saying, hey, we don't want your crapple, but I want Xbox's crapple, at least on my PC, and that's why I have Game Pass for PC, or rather, now I have PC Game Pass, okay? Xbox, Microsoft changing their name for it in their super important patch notes. Logo has been updated, that's it, really that's it. It used to have for PC on the left in a little box, now it says PC in the front. Nothing else, just the logo changed a bit. We're still Xbox, we're still on PC, not a big deal really, we just like this version more. Change is good usually, in this case, change is kind of neutral. It is just a little weird with Microsoft, and the fact that you're being like, so meme kid about it bothers me just so slightly. And I know kickstarting products and not getting them on time bothers people, but the Analog Pocket's supposed to be coming out or start shipping as of today, December 13th. And with that, they're announcing that they're gonna start accepting more pre-orders or back orders, whatever you wanna call it, as of December 14th at 8 a.m. Pacific time, in case you didn't get into the first round and you wanna get into this one. And then on Thursday, after I filmed the Friday episode of Hot News, the Video Game Awards took place. And I just wanna talk about a few announcements that happened from that. Number one, the game of the year was It Takes Two Still haven't played this. I'm planning on playing this through with my wife, but I want to hear what your game of the year was for 2021. If you can type it down below in the comments, I'd love to hear what that was. If I had to choose, I think I played fewer games in 2021 than I did in 2020. My life was a lot crazier this year, but I would have to say it would go to Returnal, because that's like one of the only games that like I actually played through and beat and was like, yes, I thoroughly enjoyed that experience from top to bottom. So let me know your game of the year down below in the comments, not necessarily what these game journalists, critics, people who are paid by the games media think, but your specific one. We also got a new trailer for Forspoken, which is the new RPG that's coming out from Square Enix, coming out on May 24th. It's gonna be on PC and PS5. We're also getting the PC release of Final Fantasy VII Remake Integrate. It's coming out to PC as of December 16th, this week. So just a week in between announcement and when it's launching. But there's kind of a bit of controversy behind this, because number one, it's an Epic Games Store exclusive, which if I'm not mistaken, is the first PlayStation kind of exclusive game that is coming out on PC that's held to the Epic Games Store. It's not quite the same because this isn't a Sony first party title. This was made by Square Enix, so it's not like Horizon Zero Dawn of God of War, but that's ruffling a little people's jimmies. And then we also have the fact that it's gonna be a $70 price, which is just not sitting well with a lot of people. It's a very expensive game. What do you think of Final Fantasy VII Remake on PC and all that comes with it? And all that came with the Video Game Awards was Intel teasing out the Arc GPU. They want us to know they're still here, right? They're trying to get us teased with it with a teaser that really doesn't show a whole lot. It shows that it can play video games, which I really hope a GPU can do. It can do accelerated game streaming. You can see that there is a computer over here. There's a GPU right there. There are cable extensions right there. What are they running, huh? What's going on? Intel, give us more information. I want more info on the GPUs. If I had to guess, they're gonna be announcing this at CES. January 4th is their keynote, so likely stay tuned for that to happen. And then we'll have to see if this is a paper launch, if they're actually gonna come out with the cards in a reasonable time frame. There is some rumbling rumors behind the scenes that it's a little chaotic, that we might not actually get all of the GPUs in Q1, but we'll have to wait and see. But you don't have to see me no more, because this episode of Hot News is over. Actually, I do want to say, as a bit of a housekeeping note, my son is actually getting surgery tomorrow, and I'm going to try to film some Hot News while I'm out on the road, so just bear with us. If there is no Hot News tomorrow, it's because I wasn't successful. If there is Hot News, it will be in a hotel room, so just stick with me. It's a minor surgery. It's kind of a big deal, but it's not, the incisions aren't, like, the surgery itself isn't a big deal, but what it's doing is a big deal. I'll talk a little bit more about it after it happens. Anyways, thank you so much for your support. I'll see you in the next episode of Hot News later on. Goodbye.